When the state Centennial Commission popped the question to City of Prescott officials, can you host Arizona's 100th birthday party? Adding, all we'll need is 9 square blocks of your downtown, transportation, facilities, and entertainment for about 70,000 visitors. Well, it's no wonder a few eyebrows were raised at City Hall. That inquiry led to the Prescott Best Fest, the first leg of a statewide celebration and the largest single event ever held in the history of everybody's hometown. But this once-in-a-lifetime celebration almost didn't happen.
Our governor-appointed commission and foundation started with Napolitano. So at that time, we were appropriated $4 million for the Centennial Commission Foundation. However, over the past couple of years, with the economic downturn, all of the budget cuts, all $4 million of those dollars were taken away.
That sweep placed the Centennial celebration plans in limbo and initiated a fundraising scramble through the private sector in an effort to keep the State Commission's ambitious vision and planning timeline on track.
We had one shot at this. We have one chance to celebrate our centennial. It has to be the best, which is where Best Fest came in.
Centennial Commission Executive Director Karen Churchard had, in the past, worked with Entertainment Solutions, a Scottsdale-based event management company. As the scope of the Best Fest celebration grew, the commission concluded that Entertainment Solutions, with their experience in producing large events in major metro markets, was the best fit to run with the Best Fest.
When we knew that this is the concept we wanted to bring together, we knew the company to do the job.
Initially, we were asked to sit on a committee and kind of formulate a plan, an overall plan for the Centennial celebration. And so we met with a bunch of people and we all kind of brainstormed and kind of narrowed it down to 6 or 7 major projects. And one of them was a Best Fest concept.
After nearly a year of intense preparation, funding remained in jeopardy, and organizers continued to run on the proverbial wing and a prayer. Still, the major players, the City of Prescott, the Downtown Partnership, and Yavapai County, threw in their support, but not without trepidation.
Yeah, well, I remember when they first came to us, they were talking about these grandiose plans that they had for a street festival that would encompass 9 square blocks of downtown Prescott. Now, they had some vague ideas of how they were going to accomplish this, but what they didn't have was funding.
It was a little frightening when you first talk about the number of streets and the length of the street closures. We're primarily small businesses, and they need deliveries. They have a lot of employees that need to get in and need to get out at night. And there was a lot of concern.
The logistical standpoint of how do you bring in 70,000 people to Prescott over a short period of time in a very small area was something we were very concerned about. We started off right from the very beginning with every major department within the city, police, fire, streets, solid waste, tourism, obviously, public affairs, all of us coming together.
While city and county officials were dealing with local infrastructure details, the commission and Entertainment Solutions were moving forward with development of the programming schedule.
We wanted to create an event that could travel to all of the territorial capitals. We wanted to make sure that we hit the regions. We wanted to incorporate the entire state, bring in all of our major cultures, all of our major industries that make Arizona who we are today, and bring in a lot of fun. Bring in beer gardens, wine gardens, Arizona wines, family fun zones, margarita cantinas. We wanted to bring in a little bit of everything for everyone.
Finally, sponsorship for the Prescott Best Fest was secured and all event components were in place. On September 15th, the day before the opening ceremonies, downtown Prescott began its transformation into a fiesta zone. Only one worrying detail remained. Will anybody show up? That concern evaporated within hours of the opening ceremonies. And for 3 days, the celebration continued as the crowds poured into downtown from morning till night. True to the commission's original vision, the festival featured the best of Arizona, from science and industry, to military, to heritage and diversity. Not to mention food and beverage, but mostly it was about atmosphere and fun for the entire family. As expected, it was the main stage on Cortez and Union that drew the largest audience, the crowds packing themselves in from the stage to the top of the county courthouse steps.
Don't look back at a new direction. together. The trunks of memories still to come.
As the event wound down, elected officials from every level were effusive in their praise of Prescott's Best Fest and local participation.
The commission folks that organized this event, they said that no one in the state has been more cooperative than Prescott's Centennial Committee. So, and that's evidenced by the size of the crowds here, and everything's well organized and people are having a lot of fun. So congratulations, Prescott and Yavapai County, for having the best and the first Best Fest of Arizona Centennial.
We knew we were being very aggressive in terms of the size of the footprint, but we felt that, well, and we know now that the staff was up to the task and the community was up to the task, and we together we succeeded.
To the city and county's credit, they've been unbelievable to work with as well. Police, fire, streets, parks, you name it, everyone has been absolutely amazing.
You know, I've got 48 years in Prescott, Arizona. And this, without doubt, means more to this community than anything that has ever happened. And we had Barry Goldwater here, we've had John McCain, we've had a lot of famous people here. But this is talking about Arizona, not about people. And 100 years is a long time, and I'm looking forward to the next one.
On Monday morning, downtown Prescott was business as usual, not a trace of the historic weekend's festivities anywhere in sight. Against nearly insurmountable odds, the Prescott Best Fest Centennial Celebration was, by all accounts, all measures, a resounding success. The public and private sectors, including a small army of citizen volunteers, pulled together to celebrate the true spirit of Arizona, the spirit that brought a once distant outpost of American territory from obscurity to a rural paradise. We leave you with these once-in-a-lifetime memories.
As we ring in this milestone together, enjoy your evening, knowing this moment will be marked in history and honored in the years ahead. May God bless you and your families, our century-old state of Arizona, and may God always bless and protect the United States of America. So, with that, let the salute to Arizona begin.